Welcome back to the channel, everyone, and today we'll be reacting to another Internet Historian video. This is the part three of the Shia LaBeouf series. I can never say his name right. We won't be watching part two because it was taken down for some reason, and I'm just not gonna risk that because my channel already has enough problems. I will say that I think the main thing that happened in part two is he kept moving the location to like New York and New Mexico or something like that. So, or maybe he's moving it to New Mexico. I don't know. But he kept moving the location. And they kept basically trolling him as every time he moved it. So this is just the continuation of that. So let's go.
War has changed. It's an endless series of proxy battles.
I thought that's paint for a second. It's milk from down below.
Fought by mercenaries and machines. Nanomachines inside their bodies enhance and regulate their ability.
After defeat on the battlefields of New York and New Mexico.
I was like listening to one of those movie recap pages.
Shia headed to a new hidden location. No more chanting or interaction. This latest exhibit would just be a flag waving arrogantly in front of a camera. There were no landmarks, no scenery, no clues at all to its whereabouts. It would be impossible to find, and nothing could stop the broadcast.
Okay, so he got tired of all the trolling they had to deal with, and probably got arrested a couple more times. Let's see how long it actually took them to find this thing, because obviously they found it.
Checkmate. And this would allow Shia to act smug for the next 4 to 8 years. That is, unless Pol's agents could find a way to track it down. Challenge accepted. It was to be the greatest game of capture the flag.
All right. Do not mess with people like gamers, all right? If you give gamers a challenge, or in this case, 4chan a challenge, they're going to figure it out in less than a week.
Ever. Pol began organizing. They set about gathering all the information they could on the local environment, trying to match up cloud, wind patterns, and ambient noise. Because it was a live stream, they could match the time of sunset to quickly discern that the flag was somewhere in the eastern time zone. That's 2:30.
Oh, wow. That's actually a pretty quick way to figure out where it is.
2/3 of the country ruled out in one move. Others began looking into intel about Shia's whereabouts, as it was highly likely that he was present for the raising of the flag itself. As time went on, distinct noises could be heard in the background, the croaking of frogs, suggesting water nearby. Then, the second big break, in the distance, just faintly, 2 jet streams. Pol quickly opened a live feed of all of the air traffic across the eastern seaboard, but identifying these 2 lines, amongst all of this, would be a challenge.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
still,
social media trackers found this post.
Okay, I guess I see something. So, they're showing like hacking with the Milo Pony in the
Meanwhile,
background.
Social media trackers found this post. At a small town diner in Tennessee, this waitress couldn't help but brag about her run-in with Shia. It was another big break. TMZ also reported that Shia had been seen fly fishing in the area. The search was closing in on Greenville, Tennessee.
Wow.
The hunt was moving much faster now. According to the aviation team, 2 more planes would soon be flying overhead. If they could be spotted on the live stream, Pol would have confirmation. Bingo. Mm. To further narrow down the search area, the aviation team started charting all of the flight paths of spot.
Never mess with 4chan. They're the ones who figured out where that guy who put his feet in the lettuce containers at Burger King. They figured out where he was in like 12 hours.
And planes. But they still needed more information. And as day turned to night, they got it. Pol's astronomy division used the constellations to narrow down the...
Okay, did you see that? Wow. Jeez, Internet Historian.
Astronomy division used the constellations to narrow down the angle and rough position of the camera. With this, the flight paths, and some advanced trigonometry, the candidate area had been reduced way down. Further confirmation from weather satellites backed up the claim as an agent was dispatched to the scene. As he drew close, he started honking the horn, while viewers of the live stream gave feedback as it got louder. A few minutes later...
Wait, how long did it take them to figure this out? Like, 18 hours?
Target sighted. But he couldn't just head in during broad daylight and risk Shire's wrath. Instead, he had to wait for the cloak of night. In the meanwhile, Paul got to work devising an infiltration strategy. A few hours later, the flag came down, and a MAGA hat and shirt went up.
Yep.
It was a beautiful moment, and it all took place on the live stream. Pol's Central Intelligence Agency had clocked Huindu Season 3 in 38 hours and 14 minutes, and poor Shire...
Jeez. That's crazy quick. Oh, man.
Shire was divided for a third time. Could he ever recover? Could this be the end?
He's gonna move it somewhere else, isn't he?
Well, as I was editing this video, there has been an update. The stream has gone down and the MAGA hat and shirt with it, but intel indicates that the flag will be up again soon. A drone was flown over the area, and you can see here that Shire is keeping guard of the flagless pole. In response, Operation Eagle Eye is on standby. The drone carries a sophisticated device. You can see here a MAGA hat, Confederate flag, and bucket. To find out what will happen next, stay tuned.
Oh my gosh, man. This is what you get when you paint a target on yourself on the internet, especially out in, you know, public, and you're like, yeah, I can do whatever I want. I'm famous. Oh, I'm sorry, he isn't famous anymore. Where's his paper bag at?
For Season 4.
Yeah, we're going to watch that one too. Yeah, go subscribe to The Internet Historian. That was great. We'll definitely watch probably the whole series of this one in quick succession just because it's hilarious. have a good day, everyone.